Hello everybody. Well, we thought we'd get a motorhome. It'd be great, we thought. Go around Europe, see all these countries. I've just retired, lots of time on my hands, all the time in the world to do it in. But fate had other ideas in store. As we all know, along came COVID and all our plans went to the wall. Well, the motorhome sat here on our drive for 5, 6, 8 months, if not more. No use out of it at all. We went to a pub restaurant once, Sue and I had a really nice meal. Great fun stopping out in it. But probably the biggest fun that ever happened in this motorhome since I've owned it was the little ones coming over and sleeping over in it, which they love doing that. They just love it. And we love having them over here. It's real fun. Really look forward to it. But that wasn't the reason we got it. One of them, but not the main reason. So we thought we'd do the NC500, which is a coastal route around the very north of Scotland. Very scenic. It's sort of renowned a bit now. I've not been going for very long, but it's quite renowned for being a fantastically scenic route, right up there in sort of world standards, really, as one of the road trips to do. So we're going to do that. So let's get ourselves up to Scotland. Now, why don't you join us with this little film, see what you think. We'll give you a little bit of a flavour of it, and if you like it, you can come too, or you can go too. I'm sure you'll love it. It's something we wanted to do. So come with us.
I tear out the pages that I've got in these books to find just some words to get some reward, and I'd show you all the photographs that I ever got took, and I'd play old 45s that now mean nothing to me. And you're shaking and stripping me. Let me know, let me know, let me know, let me know about all the old 45s and the paperback rooms, and it scattered all the photographs of summers and suns. And you're a real gone kid, maybe now, baby.
To the M1 and the M6, and we were soon well on our way to Inverness. We decided to break up the journey with a stopover in the Lake District, and we found the Sun Inn near Kendal, where we enjoyed a lovely meal and some local ales. Catch of the day was swordfish steak. Nom 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 nom. So here we are, just about to set off our first morning in the Lake District. Just show you the van. There's Sue having a laugh. One thing I didn't show you first morning. Always advisable to remove your step before you drive off. Lesson learned, won't do it again. So we pushed on towards Scotland, winding our way through the lakes and hills of picturesque Cumbria. Our destination planned to be the Kelpies, shape-shifting water spirits of gigantic proportions, and at over 30 feet high, the largest equine sculpture in the world. Created by local artist Andy Scott, they are a monument to horse-powered heritage across Scotland. These sculptures are definitely worth going to see, and if ever up that way, make the effort to get yourselves there. Really quite emotional to see them actually. It was phenomenal and just so glad that we went. Make it a date. The NC500 is a circular route that starts and ends at Inverness, There's much debate as to whether to drive it clockwise or anti-clockwise, and as the West Highlands are generally considered the best part of the trip, we decided to save the best bit for last. From Inverness, we pushed up the east coast towards John O'Groats and found a brilliant park up at a tiny coastal village called Dunbeath, where we parked up right at the water's edge. We nestled in between two other campers and were lucky enough to spot a couple of seals bobbing and calling within metres of the stony beach. After dropping in at the immensely overrated John O'Groats, we came across an intriguing little harbour village called Castletown. We found a park up for the night close to an old disused quarry where 150 years ago stone was mined to manufacture flagstones. At one time there were over 500 people working around this now deserted little harbour, from where the flags were exported all over the world. Many of the buildings still remain, abandoned and forlorn, so sad. Coast of Scotland is littered with sandy beaches and rocky coves. We found one or two, took Torrie down, and as you'd expect, she had a time of her life. The sand is beautiful white and the sea is very, very clear, crystal clear actually. All that was lacking was a little bit of sunshine, but maybe next time. Breakfast time in the van. Torrie, 75% of the seat. Mum, 25% of the seat. We all know who rules the roost in this van. Not us.
Is that right, Tudge? Are you the boss?
I can't afford the lightning. Oh, where did the blue sky
We came to a little harbour town called Ullapool and found a really good park up immediately behind the Royal Hotel in the car park, in fact, where they let us stay there for free, which was wonderful. Right on the seafront, actually, close to everything there is to see there, which isn't a lot, but it was a very peaceful little place. A few good things about it is we needed some laundry doing, and we found a little laundry round the back in a little industrial area, and they did our laundry for us only for a tenner, and it was all beautifully washed and folded up for us, which was great. A little Tesco store, so we topped up on those, but best of all probably was there's a place called the Seafood Shack, which is award-winning seafood shack, string of awards. It's been on TV lots of times. And there we had haddock wraps, which was absolutely delicious. Bad thing about it is the pub was shut, as all the pubs were. Never mind. Highland Coos! Highland Coos! Beautiful, placid Highland Coos! Quick pit stop in Applecross for some chips. and then to embark upon the infamous Applecross Pass. Hold tight and enjoy the ride.
I'm gonna be the man who wakes up next to you. When I go out, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. If I get drunk, well, I know I'm gonna be the man who gets drunk next to you. And if I heaver, yeah, I know I'm gonna be the man who's heavering to you. But I would walk 500 miles and I would walk 500 more than be the man who walked 1,000 miles to fall down at your door. When I'm walking,
at this point, we diverged from the NC500 and spent a couple of days exploring the Isle of Skye. Sadly, it rained and rained for most of the time, but rain means dramatic landscapes and really lively waterfalls, so not all bad news.
thoughts might hurt so bad to hear the words that keep on falling from your mouth. Falling from your mouth. Falling from your mouth. Tell me
of Ben Nevis, we found a pub restaurant that was actually open. The size of Sue's meal prompted her into doing an impression of The Scream by Edvard Munch. Travelling through Glencoe, we detoured along a most wild and rugged trail called Glenetive, very wet but very beautiful. On the last lap of our journey now, we headed south and skirted along the banks of Loch Lomond, where we stayed overnight before whizzing around the Trossachs National Park the next day.
Heal me, so heal me, and tear me. Got up in your wishing well, your hopes inside.
With our trip coming to an end, we thought about our journey home and decided to have a stopover again in the Lake District area. The next morning, we checked out Grangeover Sands, which was a one-time holiday spot for Sue when she was a kid. Strangely and quite uniquely, due to a river changing its course, the sea has receded away from what was once the promenade, which now overlooks a field. Should we name it Grangeover Grass?
Ha ha ha!